So this was not supposed to be the third video of the week. Hello everyone, this is Calliopal and today I am going to talk about social anxiety. So when I said that, you know, this was not supposed to be the third video of the week, it's because I shot a vlog yesterday. I don't know whether I succeeded in it or it was a total fail. I will be posting it once what I was planning is done. I just could not finish what I went for and it was just a bad day. It was like, you know, the circumstances were not in my control. Whether as usual, I should have just done it myself. You know, I don't know why sometimes circumstances are not in our control. And seriously, again, I was just very irritated because this was the birthday gift to myself and I'm already 1 week late. And the fact that, you know, when things don't go according to my plans, it really pisses me off. But of course, I have gotten used to the fact that, you know, some things are not under our control and life just has their own plans. And I have seen this so many times that I'm kind of used to it. But I still have to learn to not get kind of pissed off, or, you know, these things then really spoil my whole day. So anyway, I think I've gotten a little better at just kind of letting go of that situation and letting go of the anger and then actually thinking rationally of what can be done about it. And somehow all these situations just have made me understand that I should just do things myself because that's what I'm good at. So yeah, let's just begin this video. So what is social anxiety? Now, I don't know if you guys experience this, but social anxiety is something like, you know, being awkward, that feeling you feel when you are nervous, you know, in a social setup. It can be a simple thing like, you know, going to a party to meet new people, or in a bar where, you know, there are a lot of strangers. Or it can be like, you know, feeling that sweaty palms, you know, or something in your tummy. You know, when you are, say, asked to give a speech or presentation, you know, and especially it's in a room full of strangers. Or in my case, it was, you know, elocution competition. Or, you know, putting your hand up and, you know, participating in a debate. Or you can say it can be a simple thing like, you know, feeling really nervous before an interview, you know, for a job interview. So all these things are, you know, because you have social anxiety. Now, in this video, I'm not really particularly talking about the disorder because for that, I have to read more. Most introverts, I'm sure, have this little bit of social anxiety thing going on. Or you can say, I don't know whether extroverts have this thing, but a lot of people do experience that. Now, let me tell you a little bit about myself also. I'll talk about a little bit of how I have tried to overcome social anxiety. Now, this thing happened yesterday also. It was such a simple task of, like, you know, vlogging in public, but I don't know. I kind of felt so nervous, like, you know, one day before itself about the fact that I have to talk to the camera. And, you know, in India at least, people aren't used to seeing a lot of YouTubers, you know, like people talking to the camera. Of course, we are used to seeing maybe tourists, you know, foreigners, or we have, I'm sure a lot of Mumbaikers have seen shoots because we have the Hindi film industry, Bollywood over here. But then, I'm sure people are not used to seeing, because as soon as I walked out of the my building compound, you know, I have this, my tripod and the smartphone and people are like just staring at me. And of course, meeting new people, it is such a simple thing, like, you know, I have to go to a salon. But even though it was like a simple task for me, I was just getting nervous meeting new people because I get used to people and I will, you know, like just have the same set of friends and I'll go to my same set of trusted people, You know, it can be a simple thing like a salon, or it can be something for my work, or it can be my neighborhood grocery shop owner, or like now I'm used to, for example, shopping website Amazon. I get used to a lot of situations, and so I did not know that I still feel that kind of social anxiety. It was a revelation, to be honest, because I thought that, you know, being a YouTuber and talking in front of a camera, or going for so many years of auditions, and of course doing few jobs as an assistant director, etc., I thought I got over this thing. But I think my core nature is like an introvert, and I think I still get a little bit of anxiety when it comes to meeting new people, talking to strangers, I think public speaking still comes easily, but I do feel blessed definitely now. Sometimes I can just talk without a script, but I have still not experienced that, you know, having maybe a talk show, or having like, for example, Lily Singh had a book tour, and I'm sure if you see her earlier videos, you can see how much she has grown and how much she has accomplished. You know, she always talks about getting out of the comfort zone. So you can say doing this thing also for me is getting out of my comfort zone. That's why when I vlogged yesterday outside, that was also getting out of my comfort zone. And when I started doing that, I did not definitely talk in the rickshaw. But once I reached there, I talked, and I was like, I don't care, people are watching. So I got over that thing. So you can understand, I'm just talking about a normal, you know, social anxiety people feel. I'm not really getting into the disorder thing, because I don't think so. I have a disorder, but this is like a normal social anxiety which a lot of people feel. Definitely, if you have a disorder, I think it would be best to not just listen to my video, but actually visit a doctor for that. I think doctor would be the best person to diagnose you, or maybe, you know, to talk to you, and they would probably know what to do about it. If you feel basic like social anxiety like me, then I'm just going to, like, you know, give you a few points on how to overcome that. Now let me talk about a few situations, like let me give you a few examples, like especially what I go through. This is like I'm talking from childhood till now. Okay, now you might also experience this. I think it comes from the fact that we are introverts. I'm not sure extroverts have a problem. I'm not really sure about it. I mean, please let me know in the comments, like, you know, if extroverts also feel this. So like, if someone tells me to talk about a particular topic, you know, to just give a talk, someone invites me, say in the future as my channel grows, or in the past, like I have taken part in elocution competition and even won. That came easy to me. I have participated in some debates, and that came very easy to me. And I had like people laughing at my jokes, or I liked that attention. I liked that people were laughing about what I was saying, or when supposing, you know, any teacher tried to ask a question and try to get responses. I liked putting my hand up every time and giving my own perspective. Of course, when we were in school, it was just like simple things like giving the right answer. When it came to going to college, there were some teachers who liked to involve the students and get their perspective. So I liked giving my own perspective, and mostly it was something different. I always saw this, that I had a different perspective from a lot of students in the class. And I kind of knew that I was never afraid to, you know, talk about my own opinion. And I kind of knew that I was different and mature, and I had a different vision for life from the rest of the people. You know, like, there have been times when my own parents may have said something, but I have the rationality to think and form my own opinion. That came easy to me. But sometimes, if someone invited me to a party, alright, if my friends invited me to a party, I would think twice. I would probably ask them, okay, who all are coming? Am I comfortable with those people? Are there going to be a lot of strangers? And I have been in that situation where I've just kept quiet and people have throughout the party asked me like, or asked their friend like, why is she so quiet? Why is she so quiet? This happens in social situations also. For example, any family functions, any, you know, weddings I have attended, I am that quiet, graceful person who has been like just sitting there quietly, just exchanging a few pleasantries like, hey, how are you? Yes, auntie, I'm fine. Congratulations for your daughter's wedding, or congratulations when I wish the couple. This is all I'm interested in. When it comes to one-on-one conversations, like with my close friends, with my family members, I will be that person who would be dominating the conversations because I'm very good, or I have gotten good at it, you know. Maybe I was not like that before. I was the one who was just quietly listening. So why exactly does one feel social anxiety? See, number one might be like, you know, most people just hate being the center of attraction, you know, like people looking at them and they have to say something that just makes them really anxious. Next point is that we hate when people stare at us. It's almost like, I don't know, it something happens in our mind and we are like, why is this person staring at me? That's why I think most of these people, they might dress up, you know, like by covering themselves like with a jacket or something. Now, I have not really felt that when it came to dressing sense. Like I used to always wear whatever I wanted, and it was like I used to travel from faraway suburb, from Bhayandar till town, Cherni Road to go to my college. So I never cared, you know, about this thing. I used to wear short skirts and I used to wear whatever I want. But some of the people might feel that. Next point is the feeling of getting judged by others. And last point is like, you know, supposedly in a social setup, like at a party or at an event, you know, like accidentally offending someone, you know, by saying something. Or I think that fear of embarrassing ourselves. So these are the reasons. I think most of the time it's all like, you know, in our minds. So what does one go through when you feel like, you know, social anxiety? I think most of us, like, we might experience different kinds of things, or, you know, two or more of these things which I'm mentioning now, or maybe just one thing, you know, like these are some, I don't know how to say this, symptoms, or this is what we go through when we feel social anxiety. So first is rapid heartbeat, you know, when your heartbeat increases. Second point is diarrhea, or, you know, that kind of weird gurgud which happens in your stomach. Number three is muscle tension. Sometimes, you know, I have even felt something in my teeth. It might be due to some tension I feel. Number four is breathing problem. Number five is sweating, you know, dizziness. We feel like sweaty palms. Really weird, as if, you know, you're just going to fall down. Now, how to deal with this? These points are like something which I practice. I'm definitely not a professional. You know, I'm not a doctor, but this is how I deal with. So maybe if it might help you in any way, I hope so. You know, just let me know if it helps you, if you are someone who feels, you know, kind of social anxiety. So first is practicing deep breathing. You know, whenever you feel like all kinds of this fear in your mind, I think the first point is like practice deep breathing, which is like inhale and exhale. Now, basically, sometimes what happens is even in our everyday life also, we sometimes don't breathe properly. That's why, you know, yoga exercises, like breathing exercises like pranayama and all, is very helpful. And it's like, you don't have to really just know pranayama. It's okay if you just practice normal breathing. Just focus on the breathing. It should not be just short breath. It should be like long breathing exercise. So practice that whenever you feel that, before a show, before an event, before a meeting, whatever, whenever you feel like that, just practice it. Now another point is that I practice self-talk all the time. I take at least an hour to do these things for my well-being, whether it is very little meditation or whether it is prayers or something. So I do that on an everyday basis, okay? Now before an event, if you feel that kind of anxiety, whether it's going to a party or any, I'm just giving you an example, okay? So just practice self-talk before you leave the house. Go to that washroom and just like stand there in front of the mirror and just give yourself like a pep talk, alright? Maybe it might help you. Point number three is to calm your mind. Most of the time it's all like, you know, a mind game or something. You know, it's all like your mind is saying that no, you cannot do that. Oh, what if you goof up over there? What if you embarrass yourself? So I think what is important is to just tell yourself that it's okay if you goof up. It's okay if you fall down on the stage. It's okay if people laugh at you. Why don't you just like make jokes about it? If something like that ever happens, I think sometimes, I don't know whether it has anything to do with getting obsessed with perfection. I might also do that sometimes. And in that process, we sometimes just forget to enjoy that moment or to just enjoy being at that place, because we are always like constantly just thinking about it, you know. So I think that's, it's very important to just ease up a bit, do whatever you have to. Everyone has different ways to, you know, loosen up. And drink lots of water, hydrate yourself. Next point is like, you know, I think a lot of people might be, you know, shy. They are genuinely shy and that's why they feel this kind of social anxiety when they are outside. And that's okay. Don't beat yourself up, you know, because of your nature. I think so many amazing leaders and so many amazing motivational speakers, or maybe even actors, you know, are like introverts, and it's okay. We kind of plan very well. So that brings me to this next point, which is like prepare. You know, whether you need to go and prepare for this interview, or whether it's an event, whether it's a public speaking event or it's a party, it's okay if you practice. It's okay if you practice with your partner, or if you have to write down the script and you have to say that all over again, you know, practice it. It's no shame in doing that. There are people like extroverts who are spontaneous. I don't know what I am. I don't know. I think I'm an introvert, but sometimes I might be spontaneous. Sometimes I have not been, and then I've cried because I'm not spontaneous. I need to prepare. Don't like make me panic in front of people. Just suddenly you just give me something, I might not be able to. But I think with practice I have become a little bit spontaneous, and I just keep myself prepared. I read a lot and stuff like that, but I was not like that before. So that's it from me, folks. I hope you like this video, and if you like it, please give it a thumbs up. Please comment below and let me know whether this video helps you in any way. And please share this video with your friends. Please subscribe if you're liking my channel. If you think I'm making some good videos, good content, then you should subscribe. If you want to check out my last video, it's somewhere here. Until next time, it's bye-bye from me. Take care.